afternoon baseball here on the show. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the New York Yankees and the Tampa Bay Rays. That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela. He will lead this one off today.
Leading off the afternoon for the Yankees, the third baseman.
Here comes the first pitch.
Urshela.
Late swing there at the breaking ball. Must have been looking for something else. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside. The 1-1. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Left fielder is on the move. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. In now is the Yankees DH, Clint Frazier, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. The pitch. Hill was born in Massachusetts. He was a fourth round selection during the 2002 draft.
Hey, when you come out in the middle round, you have to grind for everything, and that's exactly what this guy has done, and he has turned himself into a solid big league ball player.
As usual, no surprise, 72 degrees, the game time temperature here inside Tropicana Field.
I'd be shocked if this wasn't a four-pitch walk right here. He doesn't want to mess around and leave something over the heart of the plate and get beat in this situation.
3-1 the count now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Now a fastball gets the upper part of the zone for strike two. And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away.
Batting third.
So a runner on first with one out now, and that'll bring up DJ LeMahieu. He's set, and the pitch.
1-0. That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
And he connects with it. This one's hit deep out to left center field. Kiermaier is back to the warning track, and he's able to put it away for the second out. Digging in now for the Yankees, Giancarlo Stanton. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. From the belt, the pitch, a ball and no strikes. Two balls and no strikes, the count to Stanton.
He's having a really hard time finding his rhythm and finding the strike zone. It's going to allow this offense to keyhole him in big situations. He's got to figure it out pretty quick.
Margot on his horse. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Joey Wendell digs in now. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
For the Rays, the third baseman.
Now here's the pitch.
Wendell. Hey. All one's the count.
I got a ball. Kluber is coming up on a nice milestone in his career. He's just a small handful of victories away from 100 in his time at the major league level. To 1-2 now. Pops this one up. Urshela has room in foul territory. One away. And that'll bring up Manuel Margot.
The right fielder. Manuel Margot.
First pitch of the at bat on its way. And a half-hearted swing there as he tried to go the other way, and it's strike one.
Woo, that was an ugly swing. If I'm pitching right now, I'm throwing that same pitch again. That was ugly.
Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
Don't expect too many more high fastballs in this one. He is known for his sinker, keeping the ball on the ground.
Count is 1-2 now. Now the pitch.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
And there's a line drive, base hit to left field. He'll get it into second. And he will make it up to second as he advances on the throwing miscue. My goodness.
Batting third, the left fielder, Randy.
Into the box now, Randy Arozarena. Swing and a ball hit out toward right center. Judge is over to his right as he puts this one away. Two down. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Brandon Lau. Lifetime against Corey Kluber. Two hits in seven tries. Kluber pauses. First pitch on its way.
Yep, that ball went out.
One and oh, here it is. And it's a called strike to even the count at one.
That's a tough pitch right there. Curveball, kind of front hip. Your first move is to bail a little bit and kind of not want to get hit by that pitch. I can totally understand him taking that first strike.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Second inning set to go, and next will be the imposing power bat, Aaron Judge. Outfield shaded a bit to left center, the first pitch. High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one.
Ball one, no strike.
And he fouls this one off. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. There's the big breaking ball, and it's by him for a strike.
Now that's when you know it's a good pitch. He broke off a really nice breaking ball.
Oh, and meanwhile, this pitch rides too far in and winds up hitting him. Now to the plate, Gleyber Torres. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Torres.
From the belt, kicks and deals. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0. Lays off again, and it's 2-0. Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0.
This would be an absolute terrible start to the inning. After drilling the first guy, you can't allow the second guy to reach base via the wall.
3-1 the count now. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
Aaron Hicks.
He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Judge at second. Torres on at first with nobody out. Swing and a miss, and he's in control. 0-2. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Coming to the plate now, Jay Bruce. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. Here comes the first pitch.
Hey, this dude's clearly capable of clearing the bases with one swing. So I think the approach to this guy is try to keep the ball off the plate. See if they can get him to chase something.
Fouled away. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball. 2-2.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel to that one.
And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2. Gary Sanchez will be next. A double play ball to second. 4-6. Three. It's a double play, and the inning is over. Last half of the second set to go, and Austin Meadows will be the next to bat.
The designated hitter.
First pitch coming. Here it is. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. 2-0.
That's where he wants that sinker to end up, but that was a nice job of laying off.
Pulled toward right center field. After it is Hicks. He makes the catch, a great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. So the base is empty here with one away. And up next will be Willie Adames. First delivery to him on the way. The cutter runs outside, ball one. A ball and a strike. Kluber has both great strikeout stuff and exceptional command on the mound to go with it. A rare combination, but one that makes him one of the best in our sport.
Matty V, you talked about it. He doesn't walk a whole lot of guys. Well, if you don't walk a lot of guys, that means you have to throw the ball in the strike zone. And when you do, with great stuff like this guy has, he racks up the strikeouts. There aren't a lot of guys that get strikeouts by throwing the ball in the strike zone. This is one of the few that does it.
Kluber steps into his windup. Here's the first pitch. Kevin Kiermaier is at the plate now, and he's quickly behind 0-1. Now the pitch. And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. And it's a ball and two strikes to Kiermaier now. 1-2, here it comes. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
Good job to lay off that 1-2 breaking ball.
Got him looking, and that'll do it. The inning is over. Stepping in, Gary Sanchez.
Leading off for the Yankees, the catcher, Gary Sanchez.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. High and deep to left. This one's got plenty of distance. Gone! At the plate, Gio Urshela. And here's a ball hit in the air. And that is off the wall, but in foul territory. Foul ball. He flied out, leading off the ball game.
Ball one.
Now a curveball misses inside.
One ball, one strike.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Kiermaier's got a read on it. Makes the play, one away. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Clint Frazier. He drew a base on balls his first time up. Here it comes.
1-0.
One out, nobody on. And this one's too far inside, ball two.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
This is where you cash your checks right here. 3-1, you're one of the best hitters in the game. You live for situations like this.
Three balls and two strikes to the Yankees DH. Holds off on the slider, and that's a good idea as it's ball four. Next for New York, DJ LeMahieu. One in, one out, and one on here in the inning. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
Ooh, I'm shocked he got away with that one, boys. Curveball right down the middle of the plate. And for him to take that pitch looking, he had to be sitting on something else, but he should have pulled the trigger.
And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. Can't find the zone there, and it's 3-1.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's got to beat me.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Got him. Ready for another chance? Giancarlo Stanton. So far, 0-1 with a flyout.
Giancarlo Stanton.
First pitch of the at-bat.
Off the plate, ball one.
The 1-0.
Quick.
Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Leading off the inning, Michael Brasso, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Michael.
First pitch on its way.
Well, that's off the plate.
The windup and the 1-0 pitch.
2-0.
Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away.
Batting ninth.
So the leadoff man set down, and here's the catcher, Mike Zunino. He's ready. Here's the first offering. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1. A ball and a strike to Mike Zunino. Bases are empty, one man out. A 1-2 count to the Rays catcher.
1-2.
Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Now batting.
And that'll bring up Joey Wendell. First two men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better.
No,
looked like the sinker there dipped a little below the knees. Hit hard on the ground to first. Fielded cleanly, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Here's big Aaron Judge. He'll try to get it going here to begin the fourth.
The right fielder, number 99.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Judge.
Big break to the curveball, but it misses down and in for ball one.
Hey, you think the game plan is to pitch this guy inside? They plunked him in the first at bat, and they're clearly coming right back in again.
Now a drive by Judge. Deep left field. Left fielder looking up, still ranging back. Gone to lead off the inning.
Hey, listen, there's an old adage in baseball that solo home runs won't kill you. This is one of the top hitters in that lineup. So a home run, a solo home run right here, is not the end of the world.
And that'll bring up Gleyber Torres.
Gleyber Torres.
As he rips it on the ground to second. He's right there. Throw on to first. So a good comeback there as he gets the first out of the inning. Digging in the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Got to find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
Kiermaier calls off the left fielder as he takes charge for the second out. Stepping into the box, Jay Bruce.
Jay Bruce.
First offering on its way.
Nope, at the ball.
There's not too many umpires in the game that are going to ring that first strike right there. That was borderline up, even though it was in the zone.
Fouled off. And it's fouled away. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And standing in the outfielder, Manuel Margot.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
Even 1-1 count to Margot. And he fouls this one off. The 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Into the box now, Randy Arozarena. He flew out in his last at bat.
Randy.
First delivery to him on the way. Oh, and here's a drive. Well hit out to straightaway center. Looking up is Hicks. And off the batter's eye for a home run. An impressive shot to dead center field.
And with one swing at a bat, he shows you why he's dripping with tools. He's got the speed. He's got the power. You don't know how to attack this guy. You can't put him on base with a knock or a walk, or he'll just end up on second or third. And if you leave something over the heart of the plate, that's what can happen.
Now stepping in now, Brandon Lau. Let's still watch a sinker here that misses. It's ball one. Ball two.
You can see this guy's more focused at the plate right now. In that first AB, he went down on strikes.
Behind on the swing that time, and it's 2-1. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three-ball count.
Full count now, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. To the plate now for the Rays is the DH. Austin Meadows flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. Way inside with that one. A pretty easy take there. That missed. Close. It's ball two. Kluber sets his sights. Here's the 2-0 pitch. And he drops a changeup right down Broadway for a called strike.
That's a pitch he'd like to have back. You're not going to see very many pitches like that.
Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. Well, the play's been made, and that retires the side. All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring up Gary Sanchez.
We all know this guy's a real good fastball hitter. We saw how far he could hit one. He got a fastball that he liked, and he turned that thing around, and it got out of here in a hurry.
One ball, no strikes to count. Swing and a miss at the bender, and it's even at 1-1.
He hasn't thrown that pitch much all game. I got to believe as an offense, you just got to throw that pitch away and move on to the next one.
1-2 to the Yankees catcher. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone. So back to the top of the Yankee order, digging in, Gio Urshela. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Fouled away. Now the 0-1.
1-1.
Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. Edge of the zone that time, taken and ruled a strike. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Fouled off. Now another 2-2. And it's fouled away.
You know, taking you inside the mind of a batter right here, you can't get in auto swing mode. You still have to control the strike zone.
And he fouls this one off. And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out. Into the box now, Clint Frazier. Couple of walks for him thus far. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
Hey, this is a huge at-bat right here. This pitcher wants to end this inning and have 3, 4, 5 due up to start the next inning.
1-1, the count to Clint Frazier. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball? Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now. DJ LeMahieu would be next. Fly ball right down the line and left. And that will end up a foul ball. 3-2 pitch. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and up next will be Willie Adames.
Not shortstop, Willie Adames.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Late that time for a strike.
Two strikes.
And they'll try to bounce a curveball on 0-2, but he holds back. It's 1-2 now. Fouled away. Hard sinker misses. 2-2. Fouled off. Another try at 2-2.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher, but you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Grounded back up the middle, and that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning.
Up next for Tampa Bay, the center fielder. Kevin.
So here's Kevin Kiermaier. A ball and no strikes. 0-for-1 after he took a look at strike 3 in his first plate appearance. And the sinker is over here, and that evens things at 1. Good pitch there down below the zone. Got him to go after it.
He's gone to the well with that pitch 3 times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out.
Now batting first baseman, Michael Brasso.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Michael Brasso is the batter now as he looks at a ball of 1-0. From the stretch. Swing and a miss on the sinker, a ball and a strike. Called strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's 1-2 now. Working for the punch out and the offering. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. And this is on the ground to short. Could be 2. LeMahieu for 1. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. Here's the first pitch to him.
Ball one. Ball one, no strike. That's ball two.
Here he comes on 2-0.
Ball three.
Got through the fifth all right, but it looks like he's a little off kilter here to start the sixth.
3-1.
Hey, pretty aggressive pitch right there up in the zone. Surprised he didn't offer at it.
Seared down the first baseline, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Ready for another shot now. Giancarlo Stanton, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Hit hard to the right, but foul. Now the 0-1. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
Man, this guy's in a good groove right now. Seven straight retired. He's locked in.
Well above the letters with the fastball that time. And it's fouled away. Two runs on two hits, and no errors for the Yankees so far. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ball game for him. Andrew Kittredge, a 6'1" right-hander, will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here. Two away now in the Yankees' sixth, and that'll bring up the big bat of Aaron Judge.
The last at bat, Matty V, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
Hey, they say solos won't kill us, but I got to believe this guy's looking to do exactly that.
Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1. Fastball right back to the mound, and he'll flip it onto first, and with it, that ends the inning. Stepping into the box, Mike Zunino, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. And a cut fastball in there for a strike. It's 0-1. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. The 1-1 home. Hit sharply on the ground. LeMahieu's got it. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow.
Up next for
so Tampa's batting order turns over and set to go. Joey Wendell. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. And he struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his 8th punch out of the ballgame.
Number 13.
So two outs now in the Tampa Bay sixth, and that'll bring up the versatile center fielder Manuel Margot. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing and one.
Hey, it's not always about filling up the strike zone all the time every inning. He's pitching well as we're moving into the middle innings, but interestingly, less than 50% of his first pitches have been for strikes.
Lifted down the line in right and back out of play. Count holds it 0-2. That's inside and low. It's a ball and two strikes. Now a curveball stays inside. Two balls and two strikes.
Hey, curveball that kind of backed up on him right there. Might have popped out of his hand just a little bit earlier than he intended.
Kluber gets the sign. The 2-2 pitch.
Four foul balls in this AB. Pitcher cannot find anywhere to go to put this guy away.
Ball three, not close with the sinker that time.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count, and he just seems to keep hanging right in there.
He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. Stepping up now, Gleyber Torres comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame.
Gleyber Torres.
First pitch coming, here it is. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. Nearly a big fly to start the inning, instead of foul ball. Yes, just behind the fastball there, two strikes now. Kittredge, playing here in his age 29 season, he was taken in the very late rounds during the 2008 draft.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
From the stretch, Aaron Hicks is in for the third time as he looks at a ball high. It's 1-0. That's inside, 2-0. Three and oh now.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
And that misses for ball four. Standing in, Jay Bruce. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Here's the first pitch to him. Fastball in there for a called strike.
One of my favorite pitches in the game right there, the old Greg Maddux equalizer. Start it at the front hip and bring it back.
Count now a ball and a strike. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Tough to get fooled any worse than that. He's in a hole now, 1-2.
Hey, I can't have one of my best left-handed power bats fishing for balls off the plate.
Still a ball and two strikes. The 1-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. Digging in now, Gary Sanchez. He was punched out looking at strike three last time through.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
A ball and a strike. Lays off the slider that time, 2-1. From the belt, the pitch. Gio Urshela would be next if they can keep this inning alive. The 3-1 pitch. And he fouls this one off. We're in the seventh inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. Popped up. Rousseau waits on it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning.
Please join us for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Leading off the inning, Randy Arozarena. And they'll need him to get something going here.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
Now here it comes.
You'll hear me say this time after time up here in the booth. You fight so hard to get into these counts. 1-0, 2-0, 3-1. They don't happen often. This is a huge spot. Count leverage. Look for him to get loose on a fastball right here.
Won't go after the 2-1 sinker, and it's three balls and a strike now.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Full count here. Here comes the pitch. Now a swing and a fly ball. And it's a foul ball. Hit the other way out toward right field. Judge is there to put it away for out number one. Next to bat will be the Tampa Bay cleanup hitter, Brandon Lau. 0 for 2 for him to this point. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Strike one to start the at-bat. The windup and the 0-1. One run on three hits and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. Fouled away. Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at-bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time.
The designated hitter,
Austin.
Kluber steps into his windup. Here's the first pitch. Austin Meadows is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1.
Hey, sometimes you have to look at it like it's not how or how many. Pitching very well into this one into the late innings, and his first pitch strike percentage, less than 50%. He'd like it to be a lot higher than that. He's making it very difficult on himself, but he's still getting outs.
Now a curveball here, nowhere close. That's in the dirt. It's 3-1.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
And that is in there for a two-out base knock. Bottom of the seventh inning, he'll go at least one plate appearance deeper after the two-out hit. Luis Sessa takes over pitching duties, looking to get that final out now here in this seventh inning.
Now pitching for the New York Yankees, number 85.
To the plate now, Willie Adames, as he takes a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1. A late swing on the slider, and quickly it's 0-2.
Got to believe you're going to get some tough pitches in this count with the base open at first. This is where you have to regroup and find a way to get a good pitch to drive in that run.
And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Number 29 enters from the bullpen to do the pitching. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Gio Urshela. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7, 8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. Two balls and a strike now to the Yankees leadoff man. The 2-1 home. Hard hit ball to second. Reined in. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. At the plate, Clint Frazier. He's 0-1 thus far.
Frazier.
He's set. Here it comes. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Kiermaier's got a read on it. He's got it, and there are two down now. And that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box. He was a ground out victim last time up. First pitch on its way.
Ball, that's outside.
Hey. Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the 8th. 1-2 to DJ LeMahieu.
Looked like he was going to wait him out, see if he was going to come over the heart of the plate. Well, newsflash, he is, and this hitter is going to adjust his batting gloves.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike 3, and that will retire the side. Bottom of the inning now, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next.
For the Red, the center fielder, Kevin Kiermaier.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. And that misses low and away. Ball one.
Ball one, no strike.
That evens it up. 1-1. Here it comes. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Judge looks up. That one is out of here. This game is tied.
Up next for Tampa Bay.
In now, Michael Brasso. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Hit hard to the right side. Foul.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Fouled off. Base is empty here with nobody out. Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-2. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one. Here now is Mike Zunino. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Zunino.
He's set, and the pitch.
1-0.
Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
Hate to do it, but I've got to question the pitch calling right there. With a guy like this at the plate.
Now, meanwhile here, this ball's hit fairly well down that left field line, and it's going to stay fair. It's a home run. Jonathan Loaisiga answers the call now, looking to get this one onto the ninth inning without any trouble.
Number 43, Jonathan Loaisiga.
Into the box, Joey Wendell. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. And this is a fastball that's right on the black but ruled a ball. It's 2-0 now. 2-1 to the Rays leadoff batter.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. Torres is under it. Two gone.
Now batting. Right
up next for the Rays, Manuel Margot. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Loaisiga, just 24 years of age. He's a second year big leaguer. That one's going to find the seats. Strike one. 1-1. Here it comes. And solid contact there as this ball is belted high in the air out to left. He leaps, but he can't get it. It's down for extra bases. And he'll coast into second here with a two-out double.
Now batting, left fielder, Randy Arozarena.
At the plate now, Randy Arozarena hit in the air down the right field line. And foul. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. He's set. The 0-1. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And it's a foul ball. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. And he looks at a ball, 1-2. And it's fouled away. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball. Shin high fastball that time, ball three. Brandon Lau would be next. Hit in the air out to right. Heading after it is Judge. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Diego Castillo takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
63. Diego.
All set to start the ninth in this one, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, Giancarlo Stanton.
Leading off for the Yankees.
First delivery to him on the way.
Giancarlo.
Count 1-0.
That's by him for strike one.
Ball, one strike.
A bouncer up the middle. On to first, and that is a big out to start the ninth. At the plate, Aaron Judge. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Outfield in the no doubles defense. Now the first pitch. Hit high and deep to right center. Heading after it is Margot. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. Now at the plate, Labor Torres.
Labor Torres.
First offering on its way. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1.
0-1's the count.
And this is swung on and missed. So with that, they find themselves down to their final strike here this afternoon. Now a swing and a ball popped in the air back behind short. Adames is there, makes the catch, and the ball game is over.
Yeah, and the home crowd is loving it as they jumped out in front in the bottom of the eighth, and they did what they had to do in the ninth to seal the deal.
A one-run game this afternoon, 3-2, the final finish. The Rays came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. Number 29 pitches well enough to get the W. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
The final line score for this afternoon's ball game.